Hey everybody, hope you're doing all right. This is the snout off of the Jackson Racing Eaton M45 Supercharger for the D16, or D-Series engines, I should say. I know in the last video I said I was going to send it off, but it's just too expensive with everything that's going on in the world, and you know, this being a luxury item, per se, I'm going to go ahead and try and rebuild it myself. So this is the snout. The first thing you want to do is there's like a little snap ring in there. It can be, almost dropped the beer bottle. It can be a star snap ring, a C-clip looking one, a regular snap ring. Just pop it off. It's around the edge in there. Once that's off, get it set up in a press and have underneath open. Let me see if I can get a shot of that. Yeah, there you go. So have it open so that the shaft can come down. And this is just a little 12-ton press. A little cheapy one. So we'll make sure everything's squared up. Everything looks good. And we're going to go ahead and press down. Oh, there it goes. Heard a pop. And it should slide down pretty easy from there. And there it went. So let me pause it and get it out. Alright, so once it drops out, you have your shaft, your pulley shaft, with one bearing on it and a coupler. And then you have your snout housing, which has the seal and one bearing inside there. So let's get things set up to try and take the bearing out. Okay, we have the snout housing flipped over so that the bearing, you can see it, and the seal is on the bottom side, so the nose is sticking down. I happen to have the correct tool to remove it, which is a 38 millimeter disc. It fits right down, and then you press it out. You can probably get a large socket down there and do it, but it's generally good to have the right tools. Let me get everything lined up. Okay, I'm not going to reuse this. Well, you can't reuse the seal. The seal's a one-time deal. I'm probably not going to reuse the bearing, so I'm just going to press it out. Everything's lined up straight. 38 millimeters down there in the shaft. And you're going to hear a loud pop, and then things should fall out. That was that pop. And the seal should be falling soon. Let's see. Yep, the seal's about to come out, which I can actually grab that by hand. And now the bearing should fall. Let me get this set up so we can see. Go straight through the case. Wipe my hands off, this stuff stinks. There's your bearing, your seal. That comes out. Your housing is completely empty. Alright, let's get the shaft in here and let's get the shaft pressed out. Okay, we got the supercharger shaft set up in the press. The bearing is taking the brunt of the load. We have the coupler there and the trusty 9mm impact Matco socket. So you have to get the diameter of that inner circle pretty filled up, pretty close. Don't use a small socket. 9 is about right. So we'll press it, and it's going to take some force, and it's going to make loud popping noises. Hopefully the bearing don't shatter. There it goes. Let me put it down so I can catch the shaft. Sorry, I'm trying to angle this. That's not going to work. Let me pause it. Alright, at this point the 9mm socket will stay inside the coupler and the bearing, and your shaft will be out. And there's a spline side on there as well. So that about does it for the disassembly of the snout. Let me get it laid out so we can see all the parts. Okay, we got the supercharger apart. Right down here, we got the snout housing. We got the snout shaft up top there laying across. The front oil seal, the front bearing, the rear bearing, the coupler, the Woodruff key, the pulley, and the pulley nut. So those are all the pieces besides the snap ring, because there's multiple different snap rings, so I'm not going to post one. But all the snap rings come out the same, and they're all around the housing right here in the inner lip. See, there's a little lip there. There's a snap ring in there. So that about does it for the disassembly of the Eaton M45 Supercharger snout housing. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.